man's in conclave. Virgin is for maiden and emulsions in quid ave. Ave Regina Virginum, celitere quid Dominum, concipi est et parias in tata, salutem hominum, tu porta celibata, ne della criminum. Domo rota cinerem, quae virum monto novi, volite infringerem, quae firmamente novi, Spiritu Sancti Gratia, perficiete comia, ne timeas et aurea segura, quae castimonia, ma ne pitite pura, Dei potentia. Ea Mater Domini, quae pacem redidisti, Angelis et Domini, cum Christum genuisti, Tuum ex ora filium, ur sin nobis propitium, exhibeat et eleat peccata, presant auxilium, vita frui beata, post hoc exilium.
Thanks for joining us for some of the best tunes ever to brighten the dark season. We tried to choose them not for familiarity, but for sheer musical appeal. And the variety reminds us musically of the many meanings and ways to share the Christmas story and spirit. You just heard three ancient melodies, no one knows how old, which tell the official story, a musical rendition of gospel events. We can picture the abbot sending the brothers to sing it to the villagers who can't read it but always enjoy hearing it again. Now another, Gaudete, rejoice. And Baroque masters, now those who sing the tunes, have their own perspectives and reactions, imagining themselves in joy and awe at the cradle side, abashed at the lowly reception for the king, fearful of Herod's pogrom, or grateful for divine help against Satan.
et in presepio.
Thank you.
So bring him incense, gold and myrrh, come peasant king to own him, the King of kings salvation brings, let loving hearts enthrone him.
Bright as dawn. devotion, odors of Edom and offerings divine. Gems from the mountains and pearls from the ocean, myrrh from the forest and gold from the mine. Bright as tempest, love the songs of my
thank you. And we're moving toward another one of these carols where the origin is very dicey. There are so many versions of this. All of them want.
Well, as is often the case, it's the unofficial version that's true. And there's a lot of unofficial versions of this story. And they're all true, of course.
And perhaps a measure of the antiquity of this would be that you'll have a refrain repeating within the verse. It's not a separate chorus. So line 2 and 4 are repeat lines right within the structure of the verse. And there is some likelihood that part of this was rescued from a notebook that a maid was using to light a fire in the 1500s somewhere in Scotland. Maybe.
Thank you.
are now, once again as folkies, charged to singing together. Good thing. And the quartet has bravely agreed to help us figure out how to lead you into the tune. Let's say the words. You probably would do well to start there. It's a song of celebration. May lamb and lion lie down together.
May lamb and lion lie down together.
Joy and wonder never cease.
Joy and wonder never cease.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Grant us peace.
Grant us peace.
And now we will sing it in unison a couple times, and you will pretend you already know it.
Right? You will.
Yep. May lamb and lion lie down together, joy and wonder never cease. Alleluia, alleluia, grant us peace. And again, may lamb and lion lie down. Delight this night away. And as you hear the chorus, We did not rehearse this, by the way, the invitation to the party, but you know, it's all dovetailing nicely. When you hear the chorus, please join in. You'll catch on very quickly, I think. That include us. This one, there was a pig went out to dig. a wonderful rural look at all of this story. And that may be the only verse that identifies the song, because people keep making up their own. And it's unaccompanied. We're just going to sing it, and you're going to sing it with us. And it goes something like this. It goes exactly like this. I'm going to sing, "There was a pig went out to dig," and your response is, "Christmas Day, Christmas Day." "There was a pig went out to dig, Christmas Day in the morning." But there's more. "There was a sparrow went out to harrow,
Christmas Day, Christmas Day."
"There was a sparrow went out to harrow,
Christmas Day in the morning."
"There was a crow went out to," what do you think?
Oh.
"So ho, so ho." No. All right, let's make an agreement.
So.
"There was a crow went out to sow,
Christmas Day, Christmas Day."
"There was a crow went out to sow,
Christmas Day in the morning."
"There was a sheep went out to reap."
Yeah.
"Christmas Day, Christmas Day."
"There was a sheep went out to reap,
Christmas Day in the morning."
"There was a drake went out to
rave."
Yes.
"Christmas Day, Christmas Day."
"There was a drake went out to rake,
Christmas Day in the morning."
"There was a minnow went out to
minnow,
Christmas Day, Christmas Day."
"There was a minnow went out to winnow,
Christmas Day in the morning."
And take it from the top one time, "There was a pig went out to dig." "There was a pig went out to dig,
Christmas Day, Christmas Day."
"There was a pig went out to dig,
Christmas Day in the morning."
Nicely done. Those are the ones we don't forget, right? And Bennett deserves encouragement to perform this song. He really had not realized quite what he'd written, I think, when he started. And so maybe you'll tell us a little about it while I tune.
It's a work in progress. Well, no, it can't be a work in progress. It's finished. This is a debut. It's never seen the light of day before. People are the first people to hear this. I wrote it many years ago, and I made a recording of it and figured, well, okay, that's that. I don't have to worry about it anymore. And then now I have to do it. So I learned it, which is tough.
Now, wait a minute. When you made a recording, what kind of recording?
Oh, I did, you know, the basic garage band thing.
Right, just so you know. That's longer for you.
You go to a garage band, you put a blank disc in your computer, you push whatever it is, and out it comes, and you made a record.
Very simple.
Anyway, this has a whole elaborate arrangement, you see, with the voices coming in, which I'm not going to teach you. It's a blessing. Anyhow, appreciate how awful it was to be unconnected at Christmas time. This is a little song, just a reminder, I suppose. Try not to be a tiresome bring down with it. When you do this, to replicate the proper arrangement, I have to make my wife, the great harpist, Lorraine, and Hammond, just do a simple little thing over and over and over and over and over and over again. This is just art music.
Root for me, friends. Shall I? Yeah. Some of the available notes that you would expect if you were piano trained, for example. Try them out.
Don't let anybody tell you that's a hyphenated harp either. That is a harp. It's not any kind of harp. It's a harp. It's not a kind of, you know, something. It's a. This is the original thing. The Irish invented it, you know, the curve there. Bunch of other things. The Egyptians and everybody, they tried to make harps. They couldn't do it. They tried to get some vine, collapse. Well, the Irish, being the most warlike people on earth, needed a weapon of war. So they invented the triangle, and they stuck the strings on it. And that gave it rigidity, which made it very strong, and they could tune it very tight, and then they could hold it up, and it would shriek in the wind. It would make the bagpipes sound like a bunch of songbirds. And the harp is going like that, scary, Jesus. You notice that it's their national symbol, the Irish, the harp is. And they're the most warlike people on earth, ain't they?
Where are you going? Yes. He knows how to really get me tuned fast, you know? This song that I wrote when I was leading students who were in a singing class that I was teaching at the Boston Center for Adult Education ever so long ago. And we were out downtown, kind of the end of the class, Christmas caroling. And this song comes directly from things that happened that bitter night in Boston.
Shadow of my left shoulder, sun rising in the east.
Sequestered herself, and God appears as a handsome young man and says, I'm prepared to give you a son. And she says, how can that be? I'm chaste. And God says, it's easy for me. Which is my favorite line in scripture. And then later on, she's feeling very, very wretched because she's pregnant and unmarried. And she says, I wish I'd never been. And Jesus speaks up and says, be of good cheer. And shake this tree and you'll have dates and dig and you'll have water and everything's fine. And if anybody gives you a hard time, tell them you've taken a vow of silence. And so she goes home and immediately she has the baby, which the Quranic version takes the Annunciation and the birth of Jesus and compresses them into a single story. But she gets home and her family is outraged and they berate her and she just points to the baby. They say, well, how are we supposed to talk to a mere baby? And the baby speaks up. Jesus says, mind your manners, people. Be good. And he tells his story about how he's born to be a light unto the people and all that stuff. And blessed is the day I'm born, and blessed is the day I die, and blessed is the day I'm resurrected. And that's the story of Issa. Now, here's the main important thing that I want to tell you about this. Mary, the mother of Jesus, is the only woman mentioned by name in the Quran. So Jesus is very important, not just to us.
When Joseph was an old man, was he? He courted Virgin Mary, the Queen of Galilee. He courted Virgin Mary, the Queen of Galilee. We'll repeat those last lines.
That's why the last line is repeated. All these old songs. It's not because they couldn't think of something to put there.
Yeah, but so you
could
sing it too.
So you know what to do.
Well, Joseph and Mary went walking one day. Here are apples, here are cherries. Mary did say, here are apples, here are cherries. Mary did say.
Thank you.
program.
Joined by the singers.
The need for communal delight during the shortest days of the year is universal. Before the Christmas story, think of the excitement of Hanukkah, done, and Diwali, and pagan solstice celebrations, and others. Here, the next four songs are Hanukkah song, sing-along, an unabashed children's festival song, and our own Dean Groves' recasting of the tale of the winter kindness of a certain king.
Io Antiochus, Antiochus,
Io Antiochus, Melanrussia, Melanrussia,
Io Antiochus, Antiochus,
Io Antiochus, Melanrussia, Melanrussia,
Io Antiochus, Antiochus,
Mihu, Antiochus, Antiochus,
Mihu,
Antiochus, Antiochus,
Antiochus,
Antiochus, Antiochus, Antiochus, Antiochus, Antiochus,
Antiochus,
Antiochus, Antiochus, Antiochus,
thank you for singing.
Thank you.
On December 5 and 20, fum, fum, fum. On December 5 and 20, fum, fum, fum. Quartet was born this night, so rosy white. Said a fairy bird and pony in a stable mean and lowly, fum, fum, fum.
On December 5 and 20, fum, fum,
fum, fum.
On December 5 and 20, fum, fum, fum.
December is the most important day.
Let us be gay.
Let us be gay.
We go first to church and then we have the sweetest buns and candy.
Fum, 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 fum. God will send us days of feasting. Fum, fum, fum. God will send us days of feasting. Fum, fum, fum. Both in hot months and in cold, for young and old, for young and old. When we tell the holy story, ever singing of his glory, boom, boom, boom. Good King Wenceslas looked out on the feast of Stephen, when the snow was round about, deep and crisp and even. Bravely shone the moon that night, though the frost was cruel, when a poor man came in sight, gathering winter fuel.
Hither, page, and stand by me, if thou knowest telling. Yonder peasant, who is he? Where and what his dwelling?
Sir, he lives a goodly cast underneath a mountain, right against the forest fence by St. Agnes Fountain.
Bring me flesh and bring me wine, bring me pine logs hither. Thou and I will see him dine when we fetch them thither.
Page and monarch, forth they went together, through the rude winds while lament and the winter weather. Sire, the night grows darker now, and the wind blows stronger. Fails my heart, I know not how, I can go no longer.
Mark my footsteps, my good page, tread thou in them boldly. Thou shalt find the winter's rage freeze thy blood less coldly.
In his master's steps he trod, where the snow lay dented. It was in the very sod which the saint had printed. Therefore, Christian men, be sure, wealth or rank possessing, ye who now shall bless the poor, shall yourselves find blessing.
Section, the Victorians and Moderns. They were not to be outdone in deep contemplation of Christmas, and in some strains of poetry, they were comfortable sharing very personal, even mystical responses to the story.
Oh. Jesus the Savior did come for to die for poor, ornery people like you and like I. I wonder, as I wander out under the sky, when Mary birthed Jesus, 'twas in a cow stall with wise men and farmers and shepherds and all. But high from God's heaven a star's light did fall, and the promise of ages it then did recall. If Jesus had wanted for anything, a star in the sky, all of God's angels in heaven for to sing, he surely could have it, 'cause he was the King. I wonder, as I wander out under the sky, how Jesus the Savior did come for to die for poor, ornery people like you and like I. I wonder, as I wander out under the
my dying faith on.
soul to thrive. It keeps my dying faith alive, which makes my soul in haste to be with Jesus Christ, the apple tree.
Thank you very much. We have one song left to sing, but before we do that, and before we all join you at the reception outside, you know, I picked a program up right before I came up here. I want to thank some people. Thank you. I got it. We are so grateful to you for coming out today and sharing this music with us. We are very grateful to the First Parish Music Committee for sponsoring this concert and for many other concerts that they put on throughout the year, but they make a lot of music happen here. I am very grateful to Bradford Connor, music director at First Parish, and also our MC extraordinaire for the night. I thank everyone who helped with this. I thank George Eppel, who's monitoring our sound and provided us with a lot of support. And if I've left anyone out, I'm sorry, but I thank you.
Dean Groves.
I will thank Dean Groves. Who's gone? There you go.
It's right here.
Dean Groves. Yes, I know what I need to do. Thank you for the
Bob
prompt,
Bass,
George. Bob Bass up in the video. Thank you very much. And Dean also provided the setting for the first song you heard, the Adeste Fidelis. But I especially want to thank, and I would have killed myself if I had forgotten, so thank you. My guests, my delighted friends, and musical inspirations extraordinaire, Lorraine and Bennett Hammond, for coming and sharing. We will sing our final song, and this song is a modern song, but it reminds us that the ancient story of Christmas, not to Bennett, the ancient story of Christmas is, after all, the story of a child who, born to poor, temporarily homeless parents in a makeshift shelter during precarious times, was nevertheless the most important person in the world, as are all children, especially at Christmas.
Sleep, little baby, sleep. Sleep, little baby, sleep.
Sleep, little baby, sleep.
Oh,
eternal.